Coming up on the Below Deck Med After Show.
I think it would be best if you finish this trip and we say goodbye.
If it all turns back and blows up in my face, that's my decision I have to live with.
While I knew I wasn't maybe the best fit for the situation, it didn't seem like I got a fair shot.
Six people changing their cabins with two trips left to share our money with someone. It makes no sense.
Obviously, if it's interrupting the crew dynamics, you need to remove that element.
Even with music on and everyone talking, it was like,
as it turns out, I maybe did a full body. Yeah.
And then I heard about the original plan. Like, he would have probably been let go if I found out about that.
The Below Deck Med After Show starts now.
So you decide to let Delaney go.
I think it would be best if you finish this trip and we say goodbye. For me, it's causing me more stress than good.
You know, if it all turns back and blows up in my face, that's my decision I have to live with.
I mean, I feel like I did a good job.
You really did.
While I knew I wasn't maybe the best fit for the situation, there was a lot more going on in terms of me leaving than just the cabin arrangement. I think there's multiple layers to, you know, me staying or leaving, which is unfortunate. I didn't necessarily think it was fair at the time, you know, if I was going to be a hard worker, just to be like, okay, hi, bye. It didn't seem like I got a fair shot.
I kind of agreed that we didn't need the extra hands if it wasn't going to like help us in a much of a way. Like, it was Lexi and Delaney on that shift kind of together, and everything took just as long. So I don't know if that's because Lexi was obviously trying to train her or it didn't really make a difference to the trip, to be honest.
I'm just being lazy.
Six people changing their cabins with two trips left to share our money with someone who doesn't, like, it makes no sense.
I was annoyed that I was out of my cabin. I already didn't get along with Lexi, you know. It seemed like, why are there two girls doing laundry and, like, there's two other girls doing service and I'm alone in the galley? I was annoyed at the tips of split. You know, even though it's a little bit of money, I still, like, didn't think it was fair.
Like, she's been great. It's nothing on her. Like, right. It's... My concern is...
cabin arrangements.
Yeah, we have to move six people.
Yeah.
People aren't happy about it. People are really voicing that to me.
Captain Sandy really understood my frustrations. Like, I was really struggling. Like, I break down, I cry, I get emotional. So I was just like, I need to take back control, because right now this situation is controlling me, and that's why all this shit is happening.
You know, you give people the power to make a decision. They feel that pressure to make a decision. They're human beings. They're concerned how the crew are going to feel about them. You know, they want to make the right decision. They want to... It's hard. Katie's, you know, having a hard time right now, and I understand. I mean, it's normal to feel that way. The difference is, if every decision was easy, everybody would be making them.
When I told Captain Sandy that, she just supported me, and she's like, you do what you need to do your job and make sure this boat runs smoothly, and that's what I felt I had to do.
If you're fine in the interior and you don't need the help, just say thank you for helping us out with this charter. This was a fill-in. This mm-hmm. wasn't a permanent position.
Yeah.
Once you make one decision that's hard and you get past that self-talk, the next decision is going to be easier, because you're going to look back and go, wow, that wasn't so hard, and I did what was best for the boat. Obviously, if it's interrupting the crew dynamics, you need to remove that element, and that's what she's doing. Not an easy decision. Her first one, and I think she did a great job.
I have a huge amount of respect for Casey for the decision that she had taken, just because in terms of the effort that Delaney was putting in, it did show that she was trying. For Casey to put basically the whole crew above that is a big thing. That's what she really actually cared about, is us as a crew getting along. So I think it was huge on her behalf to actually take that decision and say to Sandy, I think, no, let's rather let Delaney go. It's not going to actually work with the crew dynamic.
I think it was really hard for her because she didn't understand all the crap that had gone on before. So it obviously looks in her eyes that, like, I was being nasty or something like that, which isn't. And, you know, I do hope watching the show now will give her a little bit more insight to, like, how I was feeling and what was going on and how everyone else in the crew was feeling.
I think all of the layers didn't really actually have to do with me, but I did what I set out to do. I did my best. It's not personal, it's situational.
At the crew dinner, David gets up and makes a heartfelt speech.
Yeah.
Let's hear one of your amazing speeches. Come on.
I'd really gotten to know everyone by this point, and I just wanted to have a moment to just tell people individually in front of everyone how brilliant they were.
David's speeches are probably one of the highlights of my season.
We're going to start with Delaney. You came in right when we were working. We literally haven't had a deep conversation, which breaks my heart.
I kind of felt like David like had a crush on me, maybe. I don't know. I mean, David's a good guy. He was just like friendly, you know, he's trying to keep like the vibe happy between everyone.
Katie, you have been incredible. Malia, proven that a girl can f***ing kill it in a man's
David, he always has like the most beautiful things to say about everyone. So yeah, he's such a little darling.
He's a very like caring soul.
Dave's such a sweetheart, and he goes around the room and says like nice things about everyone. Like it became like a thing, and it was so nice.
I think the best thing about his speeches is on TV they look like they're like 30 seconds long, but really they're like 8 minutes long, and we're like, okay. But they're good.
The things that he had to say about the whole crew, I think everyone was quite happy to sit there and listen to it, even if there was a couple of joking eye rolls when it went on so long.
We love him.
That might have had a rocky start.
From the first night when our chef got a little sore knee, yeah?
How are you quit? Left the boat.
Yeah, he left the boat.
He left the f***ing boat.
Yeah, he quit the first night.
As Dave was saying nice stuff about everyone, Lexi was talking to Delaney, like saying under her breath, like something mean.
The second Courtney stepped on, she stepped up.
Yeah, she did.
I wasn't surprised.
I really don't remember that too clearly. I think she was trying to fill me in because I think she realized that like I had no idea what had happened in the charter season before.
Could tell she was just filling Delaney's ear with more shit. It's just not a nice thing to do, and somebody's obviously trying to be nice to everybody and actually bring a good vibe.
David's got the floor.
Came back again.
The Ruah.
Yeah, he has. Yeah.
It's just kind of like one of those things where it's like, is it necessary to be doing that right now, or could you just let it go? And like, what was the point? Because Delaney was leaving, so it's like, why talk shit about everyone to someone that's leaving, you know? Like,
the whole point was that I was trying to eliminate the negativity, bring everyone back together and not have this negative aura just constantly bouncing around. And how many times and how many chances to give that girl? It's a shame.
The most surprising parts is that obviously I think it was the charter before, if I'm not mistaken, us three boys minus Malia had bonded with Lexi, and we thought, okay, Lexi's actually putting in a bit of an effort to get to know us, and she's trying.
This is nice.
Yeah. Harry Potter right now.
Oh. I've never watched it.
And to have that sort of scenario play out, it's just like, well, obviously this person really does not care. There's like two completely different people from one night to the next night. And it doesn't really make much sense to me, but I guess It is what it is.
It is what it is.
While everyone is partying in the hot tub, David has a pretty serious fall.
I didn't see it, but like even with music on and everyone talking, it was like
everyone's on like a high, everyone's having a laugh, it was all good and fun. You know, Delaney, bless her, she's come in, she's leaving already. And it was like, right, it's Delaney's last night, make it a good one. And then, I don't know, it just spiraled out of control.
I really don't remember it.
I was so, like, obliterated.
I really can't take the snapshots.
You man the up. I don't know, I honestly don't know. I'll have to wait till I see the episode to see if I'm in the jacuzzi or not, because I have no f***ing idea.
I remember us all being in the hot tub for a little bit, and I remember Delaney and David being quite close in the hot tub, but that's literally all I recall of that evening.
Yeah, I remember him standing or something, and then he fell.
I thought that for some dumb reason, he did like a cannonball onto the deck. It too was so loud. I don't know what he was trying to do.
Dave, are you okay?
I'm not 100% sure, but I don't know what direction I was going, but it wasn't a good one. Also, I'm pretty sure I only hit my leg. That's all I remember, is hitting my leg. But as it turns out, I maybe did a full body. Yeah.
Yeah, I thought he was going like across to come back in. So I was like, yeah, let's do it. David, I have to admit, I saw it in slow motion and I don't think I've ever laughed so hard. Because it was absolutely priceless. At the time, for a very drunk Lloyd, it was absolute, had me in stitches.
There was the locker edge and I basically slipped. So that edge is what, it was an impact injury on that thigh muscle. But yeah, nothing more than a bruise. It was sore, but you know, not life-threatening by any stretch of the imagination.
If I'm perfectly honest, for the first 2-3 minutes afterwards, I couldn't do anything but laugh. It was just too funny.
Yeah, I think I heard it and I was like, oh man. But then like he bounced back so fast that I was like, oh, he must be fine.
Dave's a champion. I don't think he even iced it. He just jumped right back in the hot tub.
As time progressed, I realized that he may have hit himself a little bit harder than I thought.
As I remember it vaguely, David had obviously fallen and I all of a sudden became a doctor.
I don't know where to look for the medics.
In the laundry.
Then I think I was trying to put like ointment, but like trying my best to sort of wrap up the situation.
Help me with my friend.
Yeah, I all I remember was you rubbing ointment on, like I was so incapable of doing it myself. But also I remember like I was freshly injured, but acro yoga was, because I remember I tried to do it and my leg just gave way. It was like, no. And then I was up in the air like a little Aladdin with Delaney. So. The 74.
And then I heard about the original plan of like climbing up onto the mast. And I was like, David, like, you're lucky you slipped then. Like, I got real, like, you know, bosun. I was like, what were you thinking? Like, he would have probably been let go if I found out about that. Like, that's just the dumbest thing. So thank God he slipped and fell. And he deserves that bruise to remind him, don't do stupid
Oh, yeah.
I'm fine.